between us is good. I'm riding this cloud, baby, ready to fly, but before I take another step, would you catch me if I fall for you? So used to standing, so used to being on my own. But this thing is new, babe. It feels like I'm losing control. I'll take another step. If you catch me when I fall for you.
Woman, you represent the church, and the two shall be one, as commended upon Saint Paul to be honorable among all. And therefore is not to be, therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. into this holy estate these two persons present, come now, present, come now to be joined. Now, if anyone can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together as of right now, please speak now or forever hold your peace. All right. Tyrone Lakeith Bell, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto you as long as you both shall live? Shamarie Renee Bolden, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee unto only you for as long as you both shall live? Who giveth thee this woman to be married? Thank you, sir. Tyrone Lakeith Bell, are you certain, before we go forward, that this is the woman that you want? There's no other woman or man out there that you want as of right now. Shamarie Renee Bolden, are you certain that this man is the man that you want for the rest of your days? Even if he lose a muscle or two, this is who you are for the remaining of your days. Amen. The wedding rings, they're beautiful, expensive, I'm sure, but it's a never-ending love. That's why it's in a circular motion. I want you to understand that when you put these rings on or off, you're still married. You go and hang out with the ladies, you're still married. You take your rings off, on or off, you're married. You go to sleep, take a shower, go to the gym, on or off, you're still married. And this signifies of your wonderful wedding, of your wonderful marriage to your spouse. Now turn the face of one another. I want you to look into her eye, and I want you to repeat these words. Say, I. State your full name. Take thee. State her full name. To be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, to death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge my truth to you. Repeat these words. Say, I. State your full name. Take thee. State his full name. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's ordinance, I pledge my truth to thee. Now, as the two of you all prepare to become one, of course, I've been praying for the both of you. And I made some notes that I've never done before. But we live in a day where people get married in January and divorced in February. And I want to make sure that I give some simple tips that your marriage will last. A lot of times, we invest more into the wedding than we actually do into the marriage. Today begins a new life as you become one. Now, the Bible is clear in Matthew chapter 19, verse 5. It says, and said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife. And they twain shall be one flesh, wherefore they are no more two, but one flesh. The both of you are getting ready to become one. It also says, what therefore God hath put together, let no man put asunder. Now the word cleave is defined as to stay very close. Whatever it takes for you to become very close. You looking into his eyes, him looking into your eyes, the two of you, and above you all, you got to keep God first. You have to keep God first. And this is why I call the triangle of love. Because it's now you, God, you, and you together. Triangle. Now, from this point on, you got to keep everybody out your business. Because if she runs and tell Montreal all of the business, now Montreal in a frenzy, and then now you all are made up, but Montreal still mad. You go tell your family, now it becomes a problem. Now you got odds and division, and now you go from a triangle to a square, to a hexagon, to an octagon, and now the marriage is all out of loop, and now we feel like saying the D word. I'll exhaust every opportunity. Marriage is hard work. It's an investment. You can't go to the bank and keep withdrawing money if you never put money in the bank. It's hard work. It's work. It's upon how much you allow it to work. So I want to share a few other things. Please understand this, that as God has to be first in your life, Shamarie, you are becoming now the head intercessor for your husband. You're going to pray. The devil don't like your husband. The devil doesn't like this. He doesn't like what's about to happen. And he will allow anything, any person, place, or thing to try to intrude into your marriage. Why? Because the devil hates marriage. And because he hates marriage, he's going to do anything he can to destroy your marriage. So you got to be the head intercessor. You have to be the head cheerleader. If he puts some jeans on, ooh, baby, you so fine in them jeans. You got to be his number one cheerleader. Hey, baby, you look good. Oh, I like that shirt you put on. Baby, you been doing push-ups. You do whatever you got to do. Because the last thing is you need is another woman telling and encouraging your man more than you. You, man, you got to be the prophet, priest, king of your home. As the prophet of your house, you got to come from the Lord in prayer. You got to go to the Lord rather in prayer. Come from the Lord after you hear in prayer and say, this is what the Lord is saying. This is how we're going to direct. As you are the man of the house, as the head of the house, you're the one saying, this is the direction I believe the Lord is leading us. Now, we share it in counseling. I believe counseling is key. We share it in counseling. It seems like you all have a clear vision of what you want. You've already shared it. Stick to that plan, and I believe it'll work. But you're the prophet. Now, as priest, any issue that you have, you take them to God. Because now you're praying and talking to the Lord on the behalf of your family. And then as the king, you're not the dictator. You're just simply the one that's going to be the provider. You're going to be the one that make it happen. It's sad we live in the day now, the woman goes to work while the man sit at home and see if Victor going to die on younger than the rest of us or not. He dropped you off at work. Okay, this is a different type. Okay. But these are the things that happen, and we've got to be the man that God has called us to be. Spend as much time together. And, you know, it's debatable when people say that love is the greatest thing. Well, that's true. I know people that love each other but can't live together. I believe communication is key. There's nothing wrong with sending texts throughout the day. Nothing wrong. Date as often as possible. Now, the success of my marriage, I date once a week. I go out of town once a month. Now, that doesn't always happen, but I do it as often as I can because dating refreshes your marriage. Anybody knows, as smart as this smartphone is, every time I have to shut this phone down and cut it back on so that it can update and be refreshed. Your marriage has to stay fresh. And as your marriage stays fresh, you will continue to go to another level. Let your love for your spouse remain stronger than your issues with your spouse. When your issues become stronger than your love for your spouse, then here comes the enemy coming in to split and destroy your marriage. But it's gonna be up to you. There are single people that are depending on you all to stay together forever. You all have to be the example. You all have to be that couple. And you know, the new word now is power couple. I don't know how you define that, but you just be God's couple, where God will be pleased in everything that you do and remain accountable. Now, I'm going to say this, and I'm closing, and I'm ready to go forward. Everybody in here probably has been in church all their life, so you probably haven't heard of this evangelist. But this evangelist named Betty Wright, she said this: you can't give up because times get hard. It's just that old devil that's trying to take you apart. But you got to, with your prayer life, let the enemy know he can't come in and destroy it, and you would go to your next level. A whole lot of people will still be married if those who say I do actually did. And as you all do this, now we're going to pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for these two. Oh God, I thank you for Shamarie Renee Bolden. Thank you for Tyrone Lakeith Bell. I speak that as these two become one, Lord, they will look to you in all things. God, keep them. Lord, bless their family. Bless their children. Bless their home. Bless them on their job. I speak health, God. I speak, God, opportunities, God, for them to prosper, and they will have a long life. Bless their families, oh God. Bless their families and keep them and use their families as support system to encourage them, to make sure, God, that they know you in everything that they do. Have your way now, which never before. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Found love in you, and I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see.
By the president of these United States.
It's like
states,
our hearts have intertwined.
And by the governor of this state called Louisiana.
Harmony.
And by the Caddo Parish and Commission. And as the senior pastor of the First Baptist Missionary Baptist Church, I now pronounce you, not man and wife, but husband and wife. I now present to you.
Hey, look, got my boy Tyrone. I'm the best man, the other best man.
Wow!
been my boy for 13 years, going on 13 years.
Got the blame.
Got the blame, my boy.
Blame, blame, blame.
You feel me?
The blame.
Can't take my boy out, but how proud I am of him.
We live.
We live, baby. My boy taking it off the mark. We off the mark. Me, I'm still single.
Okay, what y'all gonna do with it?
What y'all gonna do with
it? Understand. But look, everybody, this is Mr. Bell. Mrs. Bell, I can't tell my boy how much pride I am. How much I love her. The bottom of my heart is like a brother. Blood can't make us closer. Blood can't make us closer. Feel? Be my boy since the 7th grade, I guess. Ain't nothing else to say.
I love
my nigga, man.
I'm just about to.
My nigga. Sweet Will. Sweet Will. Oh, you didn't like Chad Bones, you heard me?
So high. So high. Oh. Maybe later we could go up to the moon. Or sail among the stars before the night is through. And when morning comes, we'll see the sun is not so far. And we can't get much closer to God than where we are. We'll go to a place only lovers go, to a spot that we've never known. To the top of the clouds we're floating away. Yeah. Ooh, this feels so crazy. Oh, this love is blazing. And baby, we're so high, walking on cloud nine. So high, so baby, so high.